The Frank Haith Show, brought to you by Don Thornton Cadillac, Pepsi, River Spirit, TTCU, The Credit Union, Bill Knight Ford, and St. Francis Health System. And now your host, Bruce Howard.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome to the Frank Haith Show. I'm Bruce Howard, joined by the head basketball coach of the University of Tulsa, Frank Haith. And coach, a home win against Tulane, a road victory at South Florida. How do you characterize the week?
Great week. Winning games is hard, and I thought our guys performed very well. You know, we got off to a slow start in a Tulane game, down 15-3, but we took control of that game by the end of the half. And then on the road, I thought our guys fought hard. We competed against South Florida team that was, you know, scrappy. But both games were really good. I saw a lot of positives.
And this was one of those occasions, or two of those occasions, if you will, where you were the favorite, which you hadn't seen a whole lot this year. Your team seemed to react pretty well to being the favorite and holding off these teams that want to come at you.
Yeah, and I think that's a difference, you know, in terms of what we've been expecting. You know, first couple games in our league, play against UConn, Temple, Memphis, we were not the favorites. And then we had to respond well in this type of environment.
And they certainly did, the Golden Hurricane, with two more victories. And we'll talk about both of those wins, Tulane and South Florida, coming up on The Frank Haith Show.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We're back on the Frank Haith Show, and Tulane against TU, coach, at home. And for the first time in a while, your team is the hunted rather than the hunter. And your team, as we mentioned before, reacted well to being the favorite.
Yeah, and we're playing a very capable Tulane team. You look at their scores, they're in every game. So they got talent, they got athletic ability, very dangerous type team.
Well, the Golden Hurricane taking on Tulane, and TU had done very well in the series coming up to this contest, and Tulsa able to hold serve at home as we take a look at the Hurricane coming out of the tunnel, and we get ready for the Golden Hurricane and the Green Wave of Tulane. In the early going, though, Coach, Tulane had the early advantage.
Yeah, as I said, they jumped on us 15-3. Early in the ball game. It was a good drive by Sterling.
And that was the three. That was the and one that Sterling Taplin got in order to get you going a little bit. But for the most part in the early going, Tulane did a pretty nice job.
They did. They have great length on the perimeter, and they really hurt a little bit with their length, their size. We had to work really, really hard to score.
And at 15-3, Golden Hurricane able to get a boost from a guy off the bench, and you never know where it's going to come from. This time, it was Lawson Carita.
Yeah, and there he is getting the offensive rebound stick back. And he had 5 quick points here at the start of this ball game. And, you know, he usually making threes. 2 of them were driving layups. Here's another one. gets an and one. And that versatility in his game, as it continues to prove, is only going to help him as a player.
So that made it 15-8, and that kind of stabilized things for you, didn't it?
Yeah, we kind of got the lid off the basket, and we started to play a lot better and on the offensive end, you know, and good penetration here by Pat, and then, you know, Pat hitting a pull-up J. You know, he had a couple of these this ball game where there weren't just threes, in which we like to see him add that to his game.
And as you can see, that shot making it 17-12, and he would make another shot moments later to make it 17-14, and all of a sudden you're on your way.
Again, another pull-up jump shot. And I think that's what we've been talking to Pat about doing, you know, just when people run at him, you know, not just settling for three. And, you know, Geno's hitting a three. Seems like he hits one every game.
Right.
We'll take those 3 points every game. But he's getting more and more comfortable being in the lineup.
And there's Corey Henderson.
Really nice find by Pat. I think it's a really good pass, and I think that gave us a nice lead. We have a 3-point lead there.
And there's your dunk with Will Magne. Magne getting inside.
Nice pick and roll, good pass by Sterling, and obviously a really good finish.
And the Golden Hurricane at that point starting to take command of the game, and as you can see, you're up by 8. Going down the stretch here in the first half. Nice hesitation move.
Yeah, I think at this stretch right here, Sterling scored like 7 straight points. And here he is back again. He scores another one on the drive, and one. Really had a moment there where he had a stretch of him being aggressive and scoring.
Kind of took over the game, didn't he?
Yeah. And like I said, he just found a lane. And Sterling's a good layup shooter and maker. And with his size, which is... has a good feel.
Nice catch by Martin Zigbanu.
Good finish there against a zone set play. Nice pass and a good finish.
So down 15-3, but now you're going to go up by 14 at halftime with that shot just before the buzzer.
Good execution there and good finish by Sterling on the drive.
And so there you see it, a 14-point lead for the Hurricane at halftime, and you'd never know it was 15-3, Coach.
No, and we just got it going there where we started to play better and we got some stops defensively, and you can see we held them down to 29% shooting at the half. And then, you know, we got some offensive rebounds, and we held the rebound at edge.
And so a 14-point lead at halftime, but that doesn't mean you win the game. You have another 20 minutes to play, Coach.
Yeah, and we came out, and it's good to see Jahlil get going because he got in foul trouble in the first half, and I think he scored all 11 of his points here in the second half.
Yep. And then a guy who would have a great second game, Corey Henderson. And this is another look at the Jahlil Wheeler, little Euro step there. He likes that, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's a good driver. We want him to get back to being that guy.
And great to see Corey get off here.
Yeah, and Corey is starting to just get more and more confident in you know, where his areas are to be aggressive in the offense.
Basket there for
Reynolds Morgan. But you can see, you know, we had the lead there and they cut it back and they made 10 threes there in the second half. Again, nice drive by Sterling.
Sterling, whenever you needed it, you know, when they kind of made their run, he helped break their back a little bit, huh?
Yeah, he's really doing a great job of attacking off our ball screen stuff.
And then he knocks that one down, and this is a terrific sequence here. He gets the basket, and then the steal, and then TK.
Yeah, and a nice pass and good finish.
And that, to me, was kind of the backbreaker for sure, it seemed like.
Yeah, and you got to give Tulane a lot of credit. They played very well, made some shots, shot the ball well. As I said, they made 10 threes in the second half.
But they kept coming, and they kept making those threes. I think they had 7 three-pointers made in the final 2 minutes of the ball game. So your team continued to have to attack, right?
Yeah, and finish and make free throws. I think we made a lot of free throws down the stretch, and you have to, you know, there's times where if teams are making those kind of shots, you falter because you're not able to get the clock stopped and then, and, you know, get to the free throw line.
But you did make your free throws down the stretch, and at the end of the ball game, as you see, they finally missed a three-pointer after making about 5 or 6 in a row, and that was that, and you see the final score at 89-82. Good, solid win for your team.
Really good win. Winning is hard. You see there, you know, we shot 51% from the floor. We had 41 rebounds in the game, but Sterling and Pat, obviously, their play offensively was really good for us.
Yeah, 24 points, 5 assists, 6 rebounds, a new career high for Sterling and Pat Bird, obviously, got it going. Good to see him shoot the ball well at home, and overall the team over 51%. Nice job by the Golden Hurricane winning that one, and now you win this game at home, a very important win. Now you got to get ready to go on the road, and going on the road is never, never easy, no matter what the opposition record is.
And I say this all the time, winning is hard, but it doesn't matter. You know, Murray Bartra, I think, had done a good job helping this team grow a little bit. And we knew what kind of challenge we were going to be faced.
In a moment, we'll be back. South Florida highlights coming your way from Tampa on the Frank Haith Show.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds, the kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We're back on the Frank Haith Show, and Coach, after the home win against Tulane, you go on the road and you're facing the team that's capable, but 0-6 in the league, and you didn't want to be the team where they get their first win in the league, right?
Well, I thought our guys really had the right mindset going on the road, playing how we needed to play in order to get a win, regardless of who we're playing against, and we had the right focus.
Absolutely. The Hurricane taking on South Florida in Tampa as TU looks to win number 4 in a row and get to 5-1 in the American Athletic Conference. And we join you from the Sun Dome at on the campus of the University of South Florida. And you got off to a better start than you did on Wednesday.
We did, and I like how we're attacking right now in terms of our offensive execution. There you see great spacing, which allows Junior to have that driving lane, and we're shooting the ball better, so people have to come out and guard us. And now you can drive the ball, and we're sharing it. So great penetration right here by Sterling. And then obviously it's reading a step-up guy. Good pass to Will and a really good finish for Will.
I was going to say, a good catch by Will as well. And into the lane you go, and that opens up Lawson Carita for a big 3.
Good drive, squeeze the defense, kick it back out. You know, we're moving the ball very well. There's another pass, good offensive rebound, kick out, don't have an angle to score. We want to continue to work on that with all our bigs. If you don't have the angle to score, kick that thing out and let somebody else play with it. And right there, Corey's wide open.
So often after an offensive rebound, you'll end up with a 3.
Yeah, because everybody's in there to block out the rebound. So those are open shot opportunities.
And here is Gino.
A good run is his 3 per game, right?
Yep.
But good running and getting the spacing, getting to the corners, good attacking.
What a play by Martin Zigbanu, huh?
Yeah, good finish there. But again, I like the drive. I like the kick out. We're getting good shots. Nice pass to Junior, from Junior to Corey. Good finish.
Corey Haith knocking down a jumper. And anytime you get those guys coming in the first half, you're playing 12 guys, and each of them picks up 2 or 3 points, it's a positive, isn't
it? It's a positive. And there's Sterling doing what Sterling does, driving and finishing.
So the Hurricane starting to take command of the game, and there's, you know, when you're ready to shoot it, when you catch it, you can get it off quickly.
Towing that line, ready hands, ready feet, good execution there.
Pat Burt giving Tulsa a 10-point lead, and now let's just knock another one in and make it 13.
And what's not seen on that is the hard roll by Martin, which allows a team has to tag him. Now you open up a pull and kick shot right there for for Pat, excuse me.
So Pat knocks that one in, forces a timeout, and you're up 28-15, and it eventually got to 30-15 before South Florida started to chip away at it.
And that was another good ball screen, right decision. And Corey played well this game, obviously offensively off the bench, 22 points, but good execution right there by him.
Absolutely. South Florida ended up making a run at the end of the half, as you can see, but a final defensive stop. And at halftime, you're ahead by five. And certainly a little bit of a concern, I would think, the way you finished the half, because lately you've been finishing strongly at halftime.
We have, and they made a run there. We had, 35 for a long time. We didn't finish well in terms of continuing to score. And then we gave up some transition buckets. So we're going to have only up five, but we knew, there were some good things. We got 20 points off the bench, which is good to see.
Yeah, and Tulsa generally dominates in the bench point area, did certainly in this game as well. So early in the second half, that's a nice drive early in the second half by Pat Burt.
Yeah, nice hesitation, good pace on his drive, under control. On this play right here, Martin probably didn't have to make that play to try to block the shot. Had him under control. By him doing that, leaves Ruben, their big kid, free on the board.
And boy, that's a nice drive, isn't it?
Nice drive by Corey. A play we call space, where we fake ball screen, open up that lane, and nice finish by Corey.
Got foul, got the and one, and the Golden Hurricane, at that point, only up by one, but you kept attacking.
Yeah, and there we set the little rub screen, and Sterling comes off that high ball screen and really makes a nice finish.
And again, South Florida hanging in there, but Corey Henderson with a big shot there.
Yeah, he had it going. He felt, he had a nice rhythm going. They go zone right here. We execute very well, attacking the high post, and Junior makes that jump shot right there at the free throw line.
Yeah, that's a soft spot in the zone, and when he can make that, he's a big threat, isn't he?
He really is. Good ball screen, little rub screen here, high ball screen, and nice finish by Corey.
And Corey Henderson has got it going right now. You can tell when he feels it that this is not a bad shot at all off of the screen, right?
No, because, and look at our spacing. Really would like Lawson to be even further in the corner. But the spacing is what you want. If you get to attack, you got an advantage there. Again, good execution in the ball screen against the zone. Nice pass by Corey, good finish by Will.
Now the Golden Hurricane up by six. As again, South Florida not going away, but you're getting those paint touches, aren't you?
Yeah, and that play right there, Junior could have taken that three, but he drove it in and didn't settle.
And then on the don't take this shot, Corey, but yeah, that's a good shot.
The guys were telling me, you hear me on the TV, said, no, yes.
A little bit early in the shot clock, but it's okay. The guy's got confidence and he's knocking down shots for you, right?
Yeah. And Corey's that kind of guy. We want him to be comfortable to shoot the ball and when he's open, and he knows that.
And a satisfying win. It ends up being a double-digit win, 79-67 over South Florida. And again, Corey Henderson with a new career high, and it's really good to see that young man emerge as he did in the game.
And I think he's an offensive player, so the more we continue, he grows and becomes that kind of guy where he's confident and he's free-flowing, he's playing free-flowing. It only makes our team better, having that kind of weapon off the bench.
And Coach, anytime you can hold somebody to 36% shooting, home or road, you got a chance to win, right?
You do, and obviously that's what we've been searching for, to get some consistency on that end of the court. And to do it on a road really gives yourself a big chance to win a basketball game.
So a big week for the Golden Hurricane, the home win, then a road win at South Florida. And TU now has won four in a row. In a moment, we'll be back with more on the Frank Haves Show. Is coming up next is our feature segment.
Baby, rock, baby, twerk, baby, rock, baby, rock, baby, twerk.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds. The kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
Welcome back to the Frank Haith Show, and on the Don Thornton Cadillac feature segment, we're going to have two of the players, Gino Artisan and Pat Burt, talk back and forth and try to guess which state is in the card of Gino. So here's your 60 seconds with.
Big Apple,
New York.
Gators,
Florida. Yeah.
Buckeyes,
Ohio.
Pass. Come on,
bro. Hey, bro. Hey, pass. I don't know nothing in that state.
Longhorns,
Texas. Don't do just colleges.
No, all right.
California, but don't do colleges. Make it, come on.
To pass. The Bayous. Baton Rouge.
Louisiana.
The Fab Five.
Michigan. Okay, I like that. Yeah.
Pat Summit.
Tennessee.
Coach Felton.
Georgia? Hey.
Well, it's good, Coach, that the guys know that Dennis Felton was the head coach at Georgia, huh?
That's yeah, nice. It is nice, but I would have loved to have seen them do more than just nicknames or cities to do a better job, show their knowledge a little bit about learning, knowing the states.
Yeah, my question is, how many passes did Gino Artisan take, and what were the names of the states on those passes? But we'll get that at a later date, I guess. We'll be back with more in a moment on the Frank Haith Show.
Hi, I'm Bill Knight for Bill Knight Ford. Come experience the difference and see why we've been Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer for 7 straight years. Sure, we have the best prices and selection, but it doesn't stop there. We're the only Ford dealer with a quick lane open until 8 p.m. for your convenience, a 7-time President's Award-winning service department, and the largest collision center in eastern Oklahoma. So go with a name you can trust, Bill Knight Ford, and BillKnightFord.com, Oklahoma's number one Ford dealer and home of the Knight Advantage.
We are American. We operate from a place of power, a place where what goes up doesn't necessarily come down, where the laws of physics are thrown out the window and high off the glass. It's power that moves us forward by leaps and bounds. The kind of power that brings the house down so the house can rise up. That's power. We are power.
Says it won't let up for a while.
The Cadillac XT5.
What should we do?
Tailored to you.
Wait it out.
Equipped with Apple CarPlay compatibility. Visit Don Thornton Cadillac.
We're back on the Frank Hayes Show, and you get ready for another busy week. You go back on the road to Greenville, East Carolina, a team that's very dangerous. And, you know, they fell behind against UConn early in their last game, but then they really charged back and were a really gritty performance.
Yeah, you got to applaud Mike Perry taking over Jeff Lebo, the job he's doing there right now. And they're a gifted team, very good athletes, very long, very capable. Their defensive numbers are outstanding. And so we got to do a good job offensively scoring those guys.
And then after the Wednesday game, it's a Saturday home game at 12:30 at the Reynolds Center. Speaking of long, it starts with UCF and Taco Fall at 7'6". But they have some other components as well, don't they?
Yeah, there's none longer than him. So there's no question we've got to do a great job. They're one of the most improved teams in our league. Very talented. B.J. Taylor, Williams, both those guys are outstanding. They have a really, really good backcourt along with Taco Fall in the middle.
Four in a row, Coach. You feel pretty good about where your team is?
I do. This is a huge week for us. Go back on the road, competing against a team that's very capable, and then coming home playing. We got a three-game home stretch starting Saturday against Central Florida.
All right, Coach, good luck this week.
Thank you, Bruce.
Head Coach Frank Haith, and we will join you next week on The Frank Haith Show.
The Frank Haith Show, brought to you by Don Thornton Cadillac, Pepsi, River Spirit, TTCU, The Credit Union, Bill Knight Ford, and St. Francis Health System. The Frank Haith Show has been a presentation of Golden Hurricane Sports Properties and a Kane Vision production.